Hello everyone, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to do a little bit of experimenting. I want to see if the frequencies make a big difference to the low conductive targets. Now I'm using the Deus with the HF round 9-inch coil. The program I'm going to be using is the hot program. I've got five targets out there and I've marked them all what I believe are low conductive targets. So let's go over these targets and switch frequencies and see if they make a difference. Okay, this is our first target. Target number one, what I believe is a low conductor. So as you see there, I've marked it off. Let's give it a try. 14 kilohertz using the hot program. There it is, 14 kilohertz. No screen. And a very, very, very nervous sound. Apologies if the wind's coming over on the microphone. It really is breezy on this hilltop. Let's go over and change the frequency to 31 kilohertz. Made it better, hasn't it? Let's go up to the top. 54 kilohertz. Get that rock out of the way. And now we're getting a little bit of a target ID coming in on the XY. So in this instance, the 54 kilohertz did make a difference to this signal. So let's have a look at it, see what it is. I think I will need the pinpoint probe for this one because it's obviously a small target. And that's it, a small piece of lead. So yes, on that target, the frequency did make a big difference. The higher frequency gave the stronger signal and it introduced the next Y screen line. Target number two, let's start off 14 kilohertz. No XY screen and a nervous signal. Quickly up to 31. Definitely coming through a bit better there. And 54 kilohertz. Yep, probably similar to the 31. There's not a lot of difference. Giving some random numbers, 93, 77. Let's have a look. There you go, another similar size piece of lead to target number one. But I thought there that the 30 and the 50 kilohertz were about the same audio intensity. Target number three, start off with the 14 kilohertz. As you can see there, targets four and five aren't too far away. 14 kilohertz. Not a bad sound. Louder. Bugger, I've gone round too many. Press the wrong button. 50 kilohertz. 54 to be exact. I'm pretty sure 30 kilohertz and 50 kilohertz give about the same audio response on this particular target, whereas the 14 kilohertz is a lot softer. Let's see what it is. Still in 14, by the way. Still nothing yet. I think I moved it then. Yeah, I did. That's the trouble with these tiny targets, they hide. I think it's somewhere around there, but I just... There it is, just... Yep, got it. There you go. Don't think it's lead, but that's a little bit deeper, that one. Another low conductive target. Now, a few people are asking me why I don't use my MI6 connected to the XP Deus. Well, it's simply because when I'm digging a hole, the MI6 is closer to the microphone so we can pick it up. When I'm digging the hole, the controller is normally back here, so you wouldn't pick up the controller audio on the microphone. That's the only reason I'm using the MI6 not connected to the Deus. But of course, when it is connected, you've got a wider range of adjustments. You can up the sensitivity on it, you can change the pitch, you can do quite a few different things, but that's why I don't use it connected. Target number four. Here we go then. Oh, that really is nervous, isn't it? Back to the frequency. Tiny one. 30 kilohertz. Ooh, big difference there, I think. And 54 kilohertz. Slightly better, I think. Marginally better, but not a big jump between 54 and 31. I don't know, really. Is there a big difference between 50 and 31? What do you think? Post your comments below. Of course, we don't know what target it is yet, do we? Let's dig it out. Once again, there's a fair bit of depth to this little target. There you go, third spadeful. Just have a look at the XY now. Little bit of difference there now, isn't it? The XY screen's looking good. I wonder if that's a coin. Don't think I'll be that lucky. Let's have a look. Lost it again, what an idiot. Thrown it away. It is in there. Right. We've narrowed it down. Oh, wow. Look at that. That, I think, is a tiny bit of a hammered coin. It's definitely silver. I'm pretty sure it is a part of a hammered coin. What about that then? I wasn't expecting to find something silver on this little experiment. 100%. I can just see the marking around the outside of it. See if I can do you a close-up in a bit. Target number 5. Back to 14 kilohertz for target number 5. Here we go then. Nah. 31. And let's go on to the XY. Back to 31. Do you know what? I can't make my mind up what frequency is best on this one. I think probably 31 kilohertz is the best. 54, it's not really getting it quite as good, is it? Let's have another look. Thirty-one, fifty-four, fourteen. 54's just got the edge on that one, I think. I wonder what it is. That's a real tricky low conductive one. You'd walk over that if you were going fast, wouldn't you? Let's have a go. It's getting better. So it was a reasonably deep low conductive target. I wonder if it improves now. Oh wow, miles better. You won't believe this, exactly the same as last time. Now it's out of the ground, there's a really strong XY. Have a look at this. That is middle of a shotgun cartridge. You believe that? Look at that, middle of a shotgun cartridge. Bugger, I thought it was a coin. Well, that's it for me. We're still learning these machines. Every time we go out is a learning curve, isn't it? So I hope that's given you a little bit of an insight into frequencies, and those mid to high frequencies on the HF coil are certainly going to be the ones to go for if you're looking for those little Roman or little hammered coins, I think, definitely. So anyway, guys, thanks for joining me, and hopefully I'll see you on the field soon. Don't forget, subscribe if you can. Let's get these subscriber numbers up. When I get to 15,000 subscribers, I think we'll do a little giveaway. How does that sound? But so far, thank you very much for your support. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you again very, very soon. Bye for now.